Good evening, doctors. Myself, Dr. Hemant Sharma, and today I am going to explain you about the muscle relaxants. So, in anesthesia topic, these are divided into two classifications, centrally acting and peripheral acting. Centrally acting and peripheral acting. I am going to explain you about first centrally acting. It's act on neuromuscular junction. For example, tizanidine. Tizanidine is an alpha-2 agonist. We are going to use in spasticity in multiple sclerosis or due to some neuropathies there is spasticity. For the treatment, tizanidine included in the tablet of Zirodol MR, we see aciclofenac, paracetamol and tizanidine component which is helpful to remove the spasticity. Another one drug is chlorzoxazone, chrysoprolol in centrally acting muscle relaxant and baclofen. It's a GABA action. What does it mean by centrally acting? Centrally acting means the drug which can cross the blood-brain barrier and it is lipid soluble. We can take this drug orally. Okay, now I am going to explain you about the peripherally acting muscle relaxant. It is included into classification like muscles, which is acting directly on muscle. NMJ is neuromuscular junction acting. So now I am going to explain you about the drugs which are acting on the muscle directly. It's dantrolene. Dantrolene inhibit the calcium ion. And drug of choice in malignant hyperthermia and neuroleptic malignant syndrome. So about dantrolene, it's enough. Dantrolene is not available in our India. Okay. So neuromuscular junction, it's divided into depolarizing and non-depolarizing neuromuscular junction, peripherally acting muscle relaxant. So depolarizing is succinylcholine, or we can say succinylmethonium. Its onset is 1 minute and last up to the 10 minutes. We are going to use in tracheal intubation and ECT. ECT is electroconvulsive therapy. It decreases the heart rate, decreases the blood pressure, and increases the potassium. It is used in malignant, it causes malignant hyperthermia and phase 2 reaction and dual block due to succinylcholine. My dear friends, so earlier we are using this succinylcholine in anesthesia, but now we are not going to use. It's past. Now depolarizing, non-depolarizing. Non-depolarizing is benzyl isoquinolone group and steroidal group. So in steroidal group, we are going to talk about pancuronium. Pan means whole. It takes a long time to excrete it by kidney. It's completely excreted by a kidney. So it is really contraindicated in renal failure. It causes the high blood pressure, high heart rate, and it is used in suicide. It causes the paralysis of the muscles for a long time. Vacuronium is a drug of choice in a cardiac failure. It is 60% metabolized in a liver and 40% by kidney. So this is safe on a renal failure patient. Its onset is a 20 minute duration. And rocuronium we are going to use in ICU. Why in ICU? Because its onset of action starts in 1 minute. And candecuronium. So now I am going to explain you about benzyl isoquinolone. It's a non-depolarizing second classification like etaracurium. It is metabolized by Hoffman's elimination. Hoffman's elimination, a lot of time they ask question, this drug is safe in chronic renal failure, CRF and CLD, chronic liver disease. It's recovery without the reversal agent. We don't need to give reversal agent, but for a pancuronium, bacuronium, we need to give reversal agent like rhenoxystigmine. Physostigmine also we can give, but it causes crosses the blood-brain barrier and we do not need the physostigmine. Adrofonium also in this group classification. Pyridostigmine also. Adrofonium we are going to use for diagnosis of myasthenia gravis. Onset of action is very small, very slow, very fast. Yeah. But the neostigmine is a good reversal agent. We can use glycolate with it or we can use atropine because sometimes these muscle relaxant causes bradycardia. That's why we can use atropine and glycopyrrolate. And sitracurium, okay, about tetracurium, it's Hoffman elimination, safe in renal and liver diseases. It can be reversed without reversal agent. And landolcin. It's a poisonous component by atracurium generated. It causes seizures. Seizures by atrocorium side effects. Cistracorium is much better than atrocorium. It is the newer one. But no, why this is much better? Because there is no histamine release. And another group like gentacorium, mevacorium, it is the shortest acting muscle relaxant. Okay, but if we overall talk about which is the most shortest acting, it depolarizing succinylcholine. So my dear friends, till here it's clear for you, I hope. And now I am going to explain you, if patient be done the operation of a patient, and after that we are going to shift him in a recovery room, and there in recovery room we are just watching his vitals, and now it's our decision to shift him in a room, or if a patient is from room, or in a general ward if a patient is from general ward, and we need to decide, we need to shift him in a ICU, but due to his vitals. But how we are going to decide we need to shift him, and if we want to shift him, we need to remember some criteria, like TrNO4 ratio must be 0.7, or if he in a lying position, he need to lift his head in this way in a lying position, and then he need to show his tongue for 5 seconds. If he hold his head, that means he is able to shift in a room or in ICU or in a general ward, anywhere. Okay, now we need to see if he is able to see his tongue, or he is able to hold his tongue between his both mouths. So this criteria help us to know he is all right. If he is moving his limbs, he is unconscious, it doesn't mean to shift in a room or in ICU. We need to wait in a recovery. Limb movement is not a criteria to shift him. So my dear friends, I hope you like my videos, and I really happy with your supports. If you like my video, please put like on it, and if you still not subscribe my channel, please subscribe it, please subscribe it. I am going to put more videos, and if you want to study any topic, you can ask me. Thank you once again, and that's all for today. Have a